All right, 713-390-KRBE. How'd you catch your cheater?
So we're going to start this off with Anne, because many people found out on their own they didn't need Rule and Ryan's roses, and we always learn something new when they tell us how they did it. Anne's about to teach me something new. I know that for sure. I've never heard of what she's talking about. Hi, Anne. Good morning.
Good morning.
Morning. Hey. Good morning, Anne. So share with us, how'd you catch your cheater?
Well, wait, before you do that, let me ask this. Hold on. I wanted the background before you tell us what I need to know about the cheater. Was it your husband? Was it your boyfriend? How long have y'all been together before this happened?
Okay, so this was my husband. We were together almost 10 years, married for almost 5.
Okay.
Okay. And then?
So I was in Virginia taking care of my grandfather, who was ill, and he ended up passing away. And so that summer, I went back to clean his house, and I was getting some Amazon packages at the house in Virginia. I was like, these don't need to show up on the dot at home. Like, I just need to turn the notifications off on the Alexa device. So I go into the app, and I'm trying to figure out how to turn the notifications off. And I see something called activity log. I'm like, huh, what is this? Mm. So I open it. Okay. So Amazon Alexa doesn't just, like, she records everything that you ask her to do. So, Alexa, mm-hmm. turn the lights on. Alexa, you know, set the AC, this, that, and the other.
Yeah.
But she doesn't just text record it. She also voice records. So, mm-hmm. I had a voice recording of my ex-husband saying, Alexa, play sexy songs at 2:30 in the morning while I am 1,500 miles away.
So he was asking Alexa to play some lovemaking music while he had somebody else.
Did you call him out right away, or what happened?
Yeah, pretty much as soon as I found out, I picked up the phone and called him, and I asked him if he wanted to tell me about the woman that he had in our room.
Oh,
and he said, I'll call you back, and hung up the phone.
Oh, wow.
Whoa. And then what, he just was going to ignore it like it didn't happen until you showed up and came back from Virginia?
Well, he called me back a couple hours later, and we discussed it, and we both, like, decided right then, okay, it's time for a divorce.
Really?
My gosh,
yeah.
Annie. Okay, so let me ask you this question. When you got that notification, you heard the voice text of Play Sexy Songs, did you then look to see if there's more stuff, or you just immediately called him?
Oh, no,
what was your deep dive? What'd you find out?
There were probably like 4 or 5 instances.
Same woman or different women?
As far as I know, the same person. I don't really know. I didn't ask too many details just because I was ready to like walk away at that point.
Had you seen any kind of signs leading up to this or just completely shocked you?
I had noticed they kind of like drifted away. But other than that, I just kind of thought we were going through a rough patch.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Sorry. So is he with that lady now? Was this a person that he stayed with, or that was just an affair and y'all are divorced
and he went
with somebody else?
I think it was just an affair. He is happily remarried now, and we have a good relationship now for our daughter.
Okay.
So there's no ill will. I'm not trying to call him out.
I mean, you were heard in a moment.
But it's a PSA, you know, for anybody else out there.
Okay, so for those just tuning in, Anne found out that through the Alexa activity log in the app that her husband had asked Alexa to play sexy songs at 2 in the morning. I didn't even know that there was an activity log. Mm-hmm. I didn't even know. Like you said, you didn't know it voice records. What's your final word there? I feel like I cut you off. I'm sorry, Anne. Go ahead.
Oh, just, you know, be on the lookout.
Do you have any of the songs that he on the playlist?
Yeah, what does Alexa say?
Do you know any of the sexy songs? Did it show up?
Yeah,
you want to borrow it?
It was Pony by Genuine.
I mean, it is a classic song.
That's funny.
Oh, all right, man. But you can never hear that song now.
You can't watch Magic Mike because that was in the first
one. Yeah, that song is on your Do Not playlist.
Wow.
It absolutely is. And unfortunately, I don't have Alexa anymore. I have to switch to Google.
Okay.
Yeah, you did.
Good Google for you. Doc. I don't blame you.
Well, wow. Ann, thanks for letting us know about the Alexa activity log. And wow, I mean, people are going to be looking up that today just to check.
No kidding.
Have a great day, Ann. Thank you so much for listening to our show. Coming up next, we've got...
Goodbye.
We have Janelle. This is, how did you catch your cheater? Whether you were the cheater who got caught and you want to tell us what happened, or you were the person in the relationship who found out. Janelle, good morning.
Good morning.
Hi, Janelle.
Good morning.
What's good the background, morning. Janelle? So, is this a boyfriend? Is it a husband? How long were y'all together before the instance of finding out?
So it's actually my daughter's dad, and we've been together for, well, was together at the time for about 4.5 years, and we have a 3-year-old daughter. And so, I mean, I've already had, you know, situations where this kind of happened before, like, you know, I caught him always, you know, every time I come in the room, he's putting his phone down real quick or swiping away. So he's an insurance adjuster and he does it independently. So they called him to go out to Dallas. And so they were like, we need to be out here for a month. And all the other coworkers, they all were staying in one hotel too. So that's something to note. And so I'm just like doing the dishes and blah, blah, blah. And I get a text on my phone from him. And I'm like, okay. I open it and it's like a picture. And I look and I keep looking and I'm like, am I like in a dream? He accidentally sent me a screenshot of him on FaceTime. He just got out the shower. This girl, hardly dressed. You could see through her top. You could see her nipples and everything.
Really? Oh, my God.
Yeah, he meant to send the screenshot to her, but he sent it to me.
Oh, my God.
Wow.
How quickly did you, did you reach back to him?
Dummy.
I just laughed. Did laughing emojis. I just said,
you did a laugh emoji is what you sent back?
Oh, busted dummy.
Yes, emojis.
And then what was his response?
Calling me. Mm-hmm. He said, please don't show your people. Please don't show your people. That was his main concern.
Well,
and
people.
Weeks. Like my family.
Okay.
My mom and my sister, because he knows I'm really close with them.
Okay.
I said, oh, too late for that.
Oh! I already said
my
to everybody.
Sister, my mom, his sister,
they
all got it.
What about his parents? Did you let them know?
Whoa. Well, they don't want to see that.
Yes.
Oh,
yeah. Oh, they don't want to see it.
Did you send them the picture?
Oh, no.
Like a send it to
text?
The parents.
Was it a group text you sent the family?
I just sent it individually to everybody, but
Wait. Just how compromised was he? I mean, was his towel off, or was it just kind of like suggestive?
Like you could tell the towel. Well, he actually had the towel over his head, like hanging down his head. He's like posing, trying to, you know, be cool. But you could see, like, yeah, he had nothing on.
Oh my God.
It's just a coworker.
Oh, that they just took a shower together.
Okay, just a coworker you're naked with on a business trip.
Yeah.
Actually
on FaceTime. They were on FaceTime. So she was like, I don't know. But, they all were staying in the same hotel, too. I could only imagine.
So it was the case of mistexting someone, and then that was over. So then when he came back from Dallas, Janelle, what happened? Was he trying to be remorseful and begging you to stay, or what did he say to you
when he got back? 2 weeks, because this was 2 weeks of him being in Dallas. So after another 2 weeks, he did come back to Houston. And, that's when he finally started saying sorry. He not once ever said sorry in between that. And
he wanted to have his fun while he was there.
Yes. And he went and stayed wherever he stayed at and just been trying to figure it out since then, because this happened in June.
Fresh. So you guys are... Not separate. You're separated, but you're not. No legal work has been done yet to end the marriage.
Well, they're not married.
So we're not married.
Okay.
Yeah.
By the way, common law.
There's a survey that came out today that revealed 40% of U.S. workers are having relations with coworkers.
Really?
40%.
Wow.
That's a lot.
People do meet at work. A lot of people meet at work.
But a lot of them are married, though.
At work. Oh my gosh, Janelle, I'm so sorry that happened to you. But whoa, what a learning lesson! Holy smokes. FaceTime screenshot,
13% of men have had relations with a coworker while married. 6% of women were married that had relations with a guy.
Hmm.
So, gosh, Janelle, thanks for sharing your story on How'd You Catch Your Cheater. And yeah, I guess you got to look out for when your mate gets a job where they keep talking about the same coworker. We've heard that on Roses a lot. They bring up the coworker's name a lot about, oh, Jeff said that was so funny.
Or a hobby.
Watch that on Netflix.
Like, so they never like sports. They don't like sports.
Now all of a sudden they're into it.
Yeah, the guy likes.
Let's get some tickets to an Astros game.
Yeah. Yeah. He's wearing the Astros. Oh, knows everything about the Astros all of a sudden. It's like, wait, you never cared when they were in the World Series. Now you care.
They have a sudden interest in anything and they know too much about it,
something could be up.